Hello, good day everyone and welcome to this YouTube channel. Today, we will be sharing with you the best settings or configurations you can apply to your Aethersx2 emulator. Whether you are just a regular user of the application or you are a gamer, this video will help you get the most out of your gaming experience. Now, before we continue, I really want to say this. I have right here with me the latest version of the Aethersx2 application. So for those with older version, to get the most out of this video, I'll be dropping the link where you can download the up-to-date version of the Aethersx2 emulator. So to get the best results, make sure you have the up-to-date version of the Aethersx2 emulator. Now without taking much of our time, let's get into it. Firstly, we are going to be navigating through the icon at the top left corner of the application, those three sticks as you can see. Now when we click that, a menu should appear giving different sections where you can tweak some settings, but right now we'll be scrolling down a little till we get to the section where we have our four options, right? App settings, controller settings, reset settings and transfer data. So right now we'll be resetting the whole general settings of the application. Now we click on reset settings, then we have this dialog should appear. We have two options, fast or unsafe, then optimal or safe. Now for best result and to get the most out of your gaming experience, we go with fast or unsafe. Once you've done that properly, a quick notification should appear saying your fast or unsafe defaults are already loaded. Once you've done that properly and successfully, we head back to the three sticks at the top left corner of our application. Once we click that, the menu should appear this way. Now we'll be going to the app settings, right? The first option in that section, application settings. Once we've clicked that, we have different sections. We have the general, the system, the graphics, the module, and so much more. We'll be dealing with them section by section. In general settings, scroll a bit till you see an option which says expand to cutout area. If that's off, make sure you turn that on. Mine is on already, so I'll leave it that way. Now after that, scroll a bit till you get to a mini section which says on screen display. Show notifications, the first option there, you turn that on. The next, show FPS, turn that on also. Then show speed, turn that on as well. Then we are done with the settings in the general section. Now move on to the system section. Under the system section, you can see a mini section which says performance, right? We click that. EE cycle rate underclocking, that's the first option there, so we click that. Now we have a long list of options right here. Now I want to say this, those with low-end devices, you go with 60%, and those with mid-range and upper mid-range devices, you go with the 75% EE cycle rate underclocking. In this video, I'll be going with the 75% EE cycle rate underclocking. So we'll be going with the 75%. Then immediately after the EE cycle rate underclocking, you can see we have the EE cycle skip, right? So you click that also. For best results, we'll be going with the maximum underclock. So you click that, then scroll a bit, you have an option which says fast CDVD. Make sure you turn that on, and if it's on your device, you leave it that way. Then we scroll a bit till you get to a mini section which says speed control, right? Speed control. Now we tweak the normal speed to about 106 or 110 percentage. So that's between 106 and 110 percentage should be okay for your game. Just depends on what game you are playing. So just make sure anything you are doing around here should be between the 106 percentage and 110. Now after settings, we move on to the graphics section. Going to the graphics section, you should see a mini section which says rendering. Immediately under that, you see the first option which says GPU rendering. Clicking that, a little dialog box should open, giving us the OpenGL, the software, or the Vulkan to either choose as our GPU renderer. In no case should you choose the software as your GPU renderer. It makes most game lag. So anything you are doing any tweaking you are doing per game should be between the OpenGL and the Vulkan. So in this tutorial, I'll be going with the Vulkan renderer. It just depends what device you own and what game you are playing. Some game supports the OpenGL more than the Vulkan, and some other games favor the Vulkan than the OpenGL. It just depends on what device you own and what game you are playing, as I've said. Immediately under that, you see the second option which says upscale multiplier. Now we click that, a little dialog box should open, giving us various numbers to choose from. Now what this upscale multiplier does is that it reduces the quality of what you are seeing, the visuals, but it's not too bad. For those with low-end devices, you should go with 0.75x native. Then for those with mid-range and upper mid-range, you should go with the 1x native. So in this tutorial, I'll be going with the 1x native upscale multiplier. Then you should scroll a little till you get to the mini section which says game display. Now immediately under that, you should see aspect ratio. Clicking that should open a dialog box and giving us four options to choose out from. The first option makes everything kind of stretchy, so we wouldn't work that. Then the second option would be kind of too small, same as the third option. So we'll be going with the fourth option, which says widescreen 16:9. Then immediately under that, you see the FMV aspect ratio. Clicking that should open a dialog box as well. Then we'll be going with the widescreen also, widescreen 16:9. Now you scroll a bit, you get to an option which says enable widescreen patches. Turn that on if that is off on your device, and if it's on already, leave it that way. Now we scroll a bit till we get to an option which says shade boost. Now turning this on, this is for adjusting the color, the saturation and the brightness of your game. So if you don't like what you are seeing, you need it to be a little bit bright, you head over here to adjust the settings. Just make sure everything is kind of balanced and okay, not too bright and not too dark. So in this video, we won't be dealing with the shade boost, we'll be turning that off. Now we are done with the graphics session, heading over to the audio. Going to audio, scrolling a bit, you should see the mini section which says advanced. Right under it is the interpolation mode. Clicking that should provide you with a list of options to adjust your sound effects. For those experiencing sound lags, distorted sounds, Gaussian will be the best option to fix all those sounds problems. So we'll be going with the Gaussian. With that, we are done with the configuration of the app settings for the Aethersx2 emulator. We'll be going back to our menu. What we're going to be doing right now is to test out certain games under those settings to analyze their performance. I really want to say this also for those who have tweaked some games on their emulator and you want to apply those same settings we just configured to those games. Very simple, just follow these simple steps. Now what you're going to do is you're going to hold down whichever game you intend to copy those configurations we did to. You should see this small dialog box. Scrolling down, you should see game properties. Clicking on game properties, it should show you this large menu, and you should see a section which says summary, and right next to it is the general settings. Clicking on general settings, you should see this list, right? The mini section here says presets. On right under, you should see copy settings. It says copy the current global settings to this game. What that simply means is whatever settings we applied, whatever configurations we did, then is going to apply towards God of War 2. Very easy. So clicking on that should give you a pop-up which says global settings copied. So that's how you can apply those settings we did to whatever game you want to. Going back, okay, so that's the first game we are going to be testing at the end of this video, God of War 2. I should pick another one from here. Okay, let's go with Mortal Kombat Armageddon. Doing the same for that, game properties, general settings, then copy settings. We've applied those settings that we did, we've applied it also to Mortal Kombat Armageddon. So if you've watched this video to this length and you haven't subscribed, be sure to subscribe, and immediately after subscribing, turn on the notification bell to be aware and to be informed when we release new videos. So thanks for watching and do have a good day.